The Pindus Calamus Battle, October 28th to November 13th, 1940. Historical background. After the outbreak of World War II, September 1939, the Greek government tried to keep the country away from hostilities. In the early 1940s, Mussolini began to diversify his policy and from July onwards became increasingly hostile. The Italian provocation culminated with the sinking of the armed merchant cruiser Elly at Dinos on August 15, 1940, by an Italian submarine. On October 28, 1940, at 3 a.m., the Italian ambassador Gratti handed an ultimatum to Prime Minister Ioannis Metaxas, which expired 3 hours later, demanding free passage for the Italian troops that would occupy strategic Greek locations. The Greek Prime Minister replied, "Alors c'est la guerre," so we are at war, which was recorded as no. Formation and forces of the two sides, operational plans. The Italians. As of October the 28th, 1940, the formation of the large units of the Italian forces in Albania were as follows. In the Epirus sector, the 15th Army Corps in the region of Camaria, which included the divisions Ferrara, Centaurs, Armoured, Siena, and the Littoral Group Cavalry Division. In the Pindus sector, the 3rd Julia Alpini Division. And in the Western Macedonia sector, the 16th Army Corps, which included the divisions Parma, Piemonte, Venezia, and Arezzo. The operational plan of the Italians against Greece bore the codename G, Grecia, and its objectives were to occupy Epirus. During the attack, they would hold a defensive stance in Epirus and an offensive one in the territorial department of Western Macedonia. The Greeks. In mid-August 1940, large-scale movements of Italian forces from inside Albania toward the Greek-Albanian border began to be observed. The Greek political and military leadership, watching these developments, decided to order a partial call to arms in order to strengthen the Greek forces. Per theatre of operations, the following Greek forces were arranged. Epirus. Developed in the area was the 8th Infantry Division under Major General Haralambos Katsimitros with a total force of 35,000 men. The division had 4 infantry regiments with a total power of 15 battalions, 16 artillery batteries, 5 escort artillery platoons, a reconnaissance division unit, 2 battalions with mobile machine guns, and 1 heavy machine guns battery. Besides these forces, the 39 Evzones Regiment of the 3rd Division had been pre-called for war and on October the 27th was ordered to move from Aetolia Acarnania to Epirus. The forces of the division were divided into 3 sectors subordinate to the direct orders of the divisional commander. These sectors were Thesprotia, Calamus, and Negrites. Overall, the spread exceeded 70 kilometers. Pindus. The Pindus detail under Colonel Davakis was set defensively from Smolikas up north to Gramos, spread over a total of 37 kilometers. It belonged to the Western Macedonia Army Section, TSDM. It had 2 infantry battalions of the 51st Infantry Regiment, a protection company, a mountaineering machine guns battalion of 75 millimeters, an escort platoon of 65 millimeters, and a cavalry platoon. On the morning of October the 28th, 1940, the 3rd 51 Infantry Battalion arrived, which took over as a reserve of the detail. Western Macedonia, arranged from Smolikas to Great Prespa Lake, were the forces of the Western Macedonia Tactical Group. Overall, there were 22 infantry battalions, 2 reconnaissance teams, and 22 artillery batteries, 7 of them heavy. The Greek forces had to implement the plans and 12A. According to the orders of General Headquarters, the following mission was given to Division 8, covering of the left theatre of Western Macedonia, from the general direction of Ioannina, Zichos Metovou. Obstruction, main effort, of the main routes from Epirus toward Aetolia Acarnania. The commander of the division determined, "The division has orders to lure the enemy to the more or less organized location Alea, and after causing him damage by general counterattack, it will seek to repel him across the borders, cutting him off from his transportation and refueling lines." The mission of the Pindus detail was to secure the location Iba in the mountainous region of Pindus, maintain the connection between the 8th and 9th divisions, and prohibit the Italians from using the Pindus mountain passes, which led from west to east. Conduct of the battle. The race for coverage. Half an hour before the Italian ultimatum expired, the enemy artillery began intense preparation against the entire front of the 8th Division. At the same time, enemy troops began to move against the Greek protection forces. The Greeks, having raised strong resistance, slowed the enemy forces and regrouped according to plan. The regrouping lasted 2 days and was set on the main line of defense, Calamis, Elea, Crampalis, Cleftis Hill. Preparations for the attack. On the morning of October the 30th, almost all the units of the 8th Division had entered the defensive location Elea Calamis, the location which had been chosen for the final battle. From the morning hours, the Italians had begun the efforts to make contact with the resistance location. The Greek artillery, which had excellent observation posts and had pointed out all mandatory ground crossings, successfully fired against the Italian units and halted their advance. The fire of the Italian artillery was generally untargeted and did not cause any problem to the Greek military forces. On October the 31st, 1940, the Italian forces tried to move their whole formation forward in order to achieve close contact with the defense location. Due to the unfavorable evolution of the Battle of Pindus and the outflanking of the right wing, the division ordered the Conita battalion to regroup on the night of October the 31st to November the 1st in order to cover the right flank of the formation. By the evening hours of October the 31st, 1940, the Italians had reached the line of Mesovuni and Doliana to the south and southwest, Paleocastro to the west at the confluence of Lagavitsa stream and Calamis River, and the Riselas and Tifliki hills. Early in the morning of the next day, 1st of November, 1940, the Italian forces tried to advance their formation. The on-target fire of the Greek artillery halted the progression. It was evident that the Italian forces were intensively preparing an attack at the location Ilea. The units of the division repelled the Italian attempts to cross the Calamis River. In the evening hours, they received new orders from Greek general headquarters. However, the division commander did not change his decision to vigorously defend the location Elea Calamis. In the early hours of November the 2nd, the Italian forces had completed their preparations to execute an impending attack. At 900 hours, strong air force raids were unleashed against the Greek location and its rear was bombed along with the city of Yanina. The subsector of Sudenia, that's Negritis sector, in which the crossings of Kalpaki and the monastery of Velas are located, Crampalis Massif and Mount Cassidiaris, was bombarded persistently and vehemently. At 1200, the enemy aircraft withdrew and the pummeling by the Italian artillery began, mainly in the subsector of Sudena and the Kalpaki hills. The damage caused by enemy fire to the Greek forces was insignificant. Early in the evening of November the 2nd, the situation appeared almost unchanged. During the evening hours, an enemy battalion consisting of elite Italian units of Albanians took advantage of the fierce fire unleashed by their artillery and managed to climb up the steep slopes of the Crampalis Hill and conquer part of it with a blitz attack. The 8th Division was ordered to hold the Kozakos-Stylianna-Psilorachi line at all costs and designed a nighttime counterattack to reoccupy Crampalis. This counterattack could not be launched immediately because of a severe storm accompanied by heavy rainfall. But in the morning of November the 3rd, the plan was implemented and the Greek unit reoccupied the hill. On the morning of November the 3rd, 1940, the hostilities were limited to artillery firefights. In order to conquer Kalpaki, the Italians again sallied in the afternoon with 50 to 60 tanks and 80 motorcycles, but were stopped by anti-tank obstacles and the effective on-target fire of the Greek artillery. The enemy abandoned 9 tanks, a vehicle-connected trench, 30 motorcycles and other military equipment on the spot. The Greek unit had put up a strong and effective resistance in the Kalamis sector. Italian preparations for a new effort. On November the 4th, an attack took place on the Greek defensive position with only the fire from the artillery and the air force. On the next day, November the 5th, 1940, the Italians executed a general attack to the entire front. This attack failed as well. The Italian forces were pinned down by Greek artillery and infantry fire in front of their defensive location and suffered heavy losses. The Italian tanks, which had been predominantly used in the Parakalamis region, were effectively targeted by Greek artillery fire and became mired in the marshes of the Kalamis River. In the sector of Thesprotia, the Italian forces under the cover of their artillery and air force achieved a minor victory. The 8th Division ordered a regrouping of its forces in the area of the Suli Mountains, Acheron River, and the objective to block the routes toward Preveza and Yanina. However, the Italian forces did not take advantage of their success. Beginning on November the 9th, the terms in the Epirus front reversed. The Italians regrouped in the Thesprotia sector, retaining only a limited bridgehead to the south of Kalamis River, which was the only achievement of the surprise attack at the Epirus front. In the Pindus sector, the elite 3rd Julia Alpini Division, supported by 6 Alpine artillery batteries, invaded. The mission was to move through the mountainous routes towards Metovo so as to cut off the eastern escape route of the Greek forces of Epirus. The Greek Pindus detail, after a hard-fought 3-day battle, regrouped in deep formation toward Eptachori. The Italian enclave that was created was dangerous to the entire Greek formation. The Greek general headquarters assigned the command of the operations to the 2nd Army Corps, which was strengthened by the Cavalry Brigade. The Corps had ordered the covering of the left wing of the 9th Division, the concentration of all available forces at Eptachori, the blocking of the crossings towards Samarina, and the undertaking of aggressive actions after the stabilization of the front. During its advance towards Distrato and Vovusa, the Alpini Division did not adequately cover its left-east flank, and thus a substantial part of it was trapped and destroyed by the Greek artillery. After their defeat, the Italian forces regrouped to the west towards Gonita. After 12 days of defensive struggle, the Greek 8th Division managed to hold the Italian 15th Army Corps at Elea Kalamas. The damage to the morale and military equipment suffered by the elite Italian troops at the hands of the Greek division forced the former to suspend their offensive operations and turn their position into one of defense.